Let's bring in our panel now. Tim Blair from the Daily Telegraph and Mark Nicholson from Stepmates Studios. Great to catch up with you, gentlemen. I'm wondering who's going to notice if their power bill goes down $75 next quarter. I wonder whether Gina Reinhart, Twiggy Forrest, Anthony Albanese, or you, any one of us three, who's going to notice it most?
Man, I reckon I'm putting my hand up for Mark noticing it most. He's got those expensive, animation tools to pay for, so he'll probably notice a bit of a slash in terms of the thing. And when we were told as kids how inflation works, wasn't one of the first lessons that if you give everyone the same pay increase, that's exactly the amount that inflation goes up? Isn't this the most obvious inflationary sort of deal in all time? Seriously?
It is quite incredible, Mark, isn't it? Just spending more money, pumping more money into the economy and trying to trick their way to make sure it's not inflationary. We're going to pay tax, our tax dollars, straight to one of evil energy retailers so that your bill will go down and we'll trick the RBA into thinking the power prices aren't so high.
Oh, you bang on. And I couldn't believe it as well on budget night. Old Snake Chalmers like didn't miss a beat. He was more than happy to say, well, you're going to get cost of living relief, but it won't be inflationary. Like, I'm not an economist, and I guess neither is Jim. He's got a doctorate in Paul Keating. But it's a masterclass, not in economics, but in deception. Like, a lot of people don't realise this as well, that the trick that they played is it will bring down CPI because they take into account rebates. So it will, on paper, inflation will go down, but real life, real world economy inflation will not move at best and will just get aggravated at worst. It's honestly, it's a masterclass in deception. I applaud them, really.
What is this? Very clever. If it does tip the official inflation rate down for a short time, Tim, the beauty is it pops back up again when the rebate runs out after the election's out of the way.
See, this is what I want to know as well about the rebate is, does it count towards the $275 reduction we were promised in December 2021 ahead of the election? Are they going to be able to say, look, we're 25 bucks up? Like, do they have the balls to try that move? Because as Mark was saying, maybe they're going to give it a shot. You know, like, all credit to them. If they don't get pulled up on it, you would give it a shot.
I reckon they'll try, and Mark, that they may get away with it as long as nobody lets Chris Bowen speak, because Chris Bowen always says those quiet bits out loud.
Which bit, Chris? Wait, I've missed it. I thought you were rolling to a clip. What have I missed?
Oh no, I haven't played it again. Chris Bowen has explained all this again. He's explained how this works: that you send out the money to everyone's power company, and therefore it pulls down inflation. That's the whole idea of it. Just like he told everyone in 2019, if you don't like our policies, don't vote for us.
Oh, that's so funny. It is absurd. They even said the loud bit, the quiet bit out loud plenty of times. I think they even talked about the idea that unemployment was going to surge, everything's going to go crazy. It's all just any desperate attempt to get re-elected, which is a real shame because it's sending the rest of us into a death spiral, unfortunately, which if you've got a property in this economy, you might as well sell your house, I reckon.
I tell you what, one thing I do appreciate about Albo and a number of politicians on the left, including even Green senators, is that while they rail against landlords and negative gearing and the like, they often know enough about it to dip into it themselves. And certainly Anthony Albanese's done that. I think he's been attacked a bit unfairly here, but he's talking about getting rid of an investment property, and his tenant who's lashing out of him is a bit rough. Here he is.
We're just looking for a little bit more of a considered approach rather than just be issued a piece of paper from the real estate agent. I'm surprised as this doesn't seem consistent with the messaging in the budget this week.
Well, there you go, Tim. It was your paper that ran this story. I mean, how could you resist it, I suppose, when the tenant is having a whinge? But really, he's got nothing to whinge about, has he? Albo's allowed to sell his house and the tenant says he's been a good landlord and he's just going to have to move on.
Absolutely. And by the way, that's the only known resident of inner Western Sydney who doesn't have tattoos. So chalk one up for that. But as well, remember the comedy show maybe a decade or so, maybe longer ago, of Flight of the Conchords, where they had a character was the New Zealand Prime Minister, and he was this incredibly unsophisticated, you know, tiny sort of personality who would be bothered by things like, for example, you know, his neighbours and such. And now we've got a national story here about our Prime Minister giving someone 90 days to get the hell out of that two-bedroom brick veneer joint. It's perfect. It's absolutely delightful.
It's a cracking yarn.